everybody. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I mean, I know I've done a couple top tens, done some reviews of wrestling, but today we're going to be talking about the new WWE game, WWE 2K16. I love this series. I've been playing it since WWE SmackDown vs. Raw 2011. I've got the rest of them. Gone back and played those, but that was the first year I really got the game and enjoyed it, you know. I was a big fan of Road to WrestleMania. Now we got the showcase mode, which is a little bit different, but I actually enjoy it. A lot of people don't like the special objectives and you gotta do this, but I like it. It's a neat little way to unlock stuff. You know, don't hand it all out at once. So we're gonna talk about what's better, what's worse than last year. So let me move that up a little bit here. There we go. It's a little bit better. I know I've got a little bit of light there. Sorry about that, guys. So last year we got career mode for the first time, and it was all right. I like the insider terms they use. You know, they're, you know, face heel booking. We're not going to push you yet. I mean, you heard a lot of, we're not going to push you yet. It was lackluster. You know, I wasn't a big fan of the showcases last year. But this year I was excited because Stone Cold was going to be the main, you know, person that we're going to build it around. And I'm a sucker for like, Attitude Era stuff. I've been going through a lot of the old wrestling lately, and that stuff is some of the best. So I was excited for it. As of right now, I've been through all of Showcase Mode. I've spent a good 4 or 5 hours in Career. I've been done a lot with Universe. And in about 2 weeks, I'm going to post another video just updating you. Because, you know, I've only had the game for like 4 or 5 days now. So, you know, you still get that honeymoon phase with a new game. So I'm going to overlook a lot of things. So let's talk about what's better. Career Mode is better. You got more control over what you do. So you can choose who you're going to go into feuds with by interfering in the matches, bum rushing them on the stage, you know, stuff like that. You can choose which titles you're going to go after through that. I mean, you do start in NXT. Last year was the, you know, once you got the title, that was it. You know, that was your goal. This year you're trying to get into... Well, not the title, but, you know, main event WrestleMania with the title, whatever. But this year you try to get into the Hall of Fame and you got little objectives. That's pretty cool. I've enjoyed the career mode. So that was good. The showcase is better this year. I enjoyed Stone Cold Steve Austin mode. I am done with it. I've been through it all. It was good. They did a really good job recreating a lot of his most iconic matches. And some that I wasn't expecting. I mean... They actually got Joey Styles to do his ECW match that he had against Mikey Whipwreck at November to Remember, which was good. They did a good job with it. I was very happy. The only thing was, it was kind of weird because they had a couple WCW matches on there. And it was weird hearing Jerry Lawler and Jim Ross call WCW matches. Where's Tony Schiavone at? But I'm sure they wouldn't want to do that. So overall, Stone Cold Mode, pretty good. I enjoyed it. Worth the price of admission alone. I loved it. And I had fun unlocking a lot of stuff for Universe, which I'm going to do later. So that's good. The commentary has been updated a bit, but it's still the same crap commentary. If you played last year, you know what it's like. So don't expect a huge upgrade there. And they actually took a step back in the graphics department. Now, I'm not going to sit here and complain about graphics, because I've always been of the mindset, if a video game has good gameplay, it doesn't need good graphics. And testament to that is Minecraft. I mean, that's the one I go to every time. Graphics are crap in Minecraft. Anybody who says they're not is lying to you. But the gameplay keeps me going, you know, so... And the graphics in Minecraft aren't supposed to be good. It's the gameplay. Same with this. I've noticed this year there's a good 15 gigs more data for this game than last year for my Xbox One version. All of that was put into gameplay. New cutscenes, new everything, new ways to play your career mode, new creation suite stuff. I enjoy making my guy. You can create a title again, you can create a show again, you can put people on multiple shows in universe mode. It's good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to give an initial score, and this is going to be out of 10, and then in 2 weeks I'm going to revise that score, and that's what I'm going to do for each video. So the WWE 2K15, I give like an 8.7, which is really high. I don't want to give out nines to everything. So 8.7, positives, obviously career mode, showcase mode was good. I still have yet to play with Universe, so bear with me on that. I'll talk to you about that in 2 weeks. Negatives are graphics, and also I've noticed on the Xbox One version at least, it tends to crash a lot. Now, I am a preview program member, so that could have to do with the new Xbox experience and there still being bugs in there, or it could be the game. But sometimes it'll take forever to load, and you'll see that little circle going for like 5 minutes, and then you just gotta restart the game, shut it down, bring it up again. I've had it crap out on me in the middle of a match, which was kind of funny because me and Kevin Owens stopped wrestling, but the little Superstars logo was still going on the ring. So, I mean, there are some technical stuff with it. So yeah, 8.7 I give it, just based off the improvements alone. There are some scary looking character models there. Renee Young is one of them. All right, she is scary. But one of the cool things in career mode you can do now is like the backstage interviews and kind of. There's like six or seven different alignment things that tells you if you're a face or a heel, but you can, shift them individually based on how you wrestle and how you do those interviews. So that's really cool. So 8.7, just initial. Give me another couple of weeks and I'll have my final. I mean, I'm not a video game reviewer by trade, so I don't have all day to do it. So 8.7. Give it a look. At least give it a rent. Go out to a Redbox, rent it, try it out. If you haven't played wrestling games in a while, this is the one to pick up. Especially if you're a fan of WWE. And I would say that, but from my top 10 games the mainstream missed, there are WWE games that aren't made for WWE fans. This one is made for the fans. All right, WWE All Stars, Legends of WrestleMania, those were the casual fans. Okay, I used to like wrestling. This is made for fans, like hardcore fans. So check it out. And just give me a subscribe if you're watching this. Give me a like. Check out my Facebook page. Give that a like. The Bulldogs Games and Wrestling, same as my YouTube channel. Let me know if there's anything you want me to do. Top tens. I'm putting some Let's Plays together. I'm trying to figure out what I need to do a Star Wars SEO Republic Let's Play. And I'm talking about the 2004 game, not the MMO. No, we're gonna do the 2004 game. That's one of my favorite games. One of the best stories I've ever played. So, if you got any ideas for Let's Plays that I could get going, top tens, anything you want reviewed that I might, be able to do. One thing I am gonna do is a tour of my game room. Probably here in the next couple weeks. I really want to show it off and show you guys what I'm working with. I'm very proud of it. It's probably it's my Zen place. So that'll be it for now. Also, I'll be posting after this one. Check out my review of the new Need for Speed. It'll be up on the site basically simultaneous with this one. So let me know what you think. Leave a comment, subscribe, give me a like, all that stuff, and we'll talk to you later. Have a good one.